crown?
The crown is in the sky. The sky is on the crown.
I think I've got the hang of it now.
Good. Next stop, the park.
To jump in muddy puddles. Are we really there yet?
Yes, this does seem a long way to the park. Are you sure you know where you're going, Daddy Pig?
Don't worry, I'm an expert at map reading.
Will we get lost like we always do? And Daddy will get grumpy?
I will not get grumpy, and we will not get lost. Aha! I can see some trees down below. It must be the park.
Well done, Daddy Pig. Now, how do we stop this plane?
Miss Rabbit said it was like driving a car, so there should be a handbrake somewhere.
Here it is.
This place doesn't seem much like the park.
Where are the swings and the roundabouts?
It's more like a jungle.
Yes, it's the jungle, and that's where Pedro is on holiday.
Ah!
Here is Pedro Pony.
Pedro!
Nay!
Hello, Peppa. Wow, is that your aeroplane?
We've borrowed it for the afternoon.
Are you having a nice holiday?
Yes, it's brilliant in the jungle. There are parrots, monkeys, and everything.
I know a song about the jungle.
Deep in the jungle, so very, very green. Swinging through the jungle, swinging through the trees. Deep in the jungle, so very, very green. Deep in the jungle, so very, very green.
Pedro, does the jungle have puddles to jump in?
No.
The jungle is nice, but we're going to the park to jump in muddy puddles.
We'd better be on our way.
Bye-bye, Pedro.
Bye-bye, Peppa.
My turn to drive. Is everyone ready?
Yes, Daddy Pig.
Then let's go. It really is just like driving a car.
Daddy, you have to go up in the air.
Oh, yes.
Side.
We use the insides to make my special pumpkin pie.
And the outside to make our pumpkin lantern.
Lovely!
Now you little piggies need to dress up for the pumpkin party.
Peppa is dressing up as a witch.
Do I look witchy?
Very witchy.
You need to do some cackling.
What's cackling?
It's how witches laugh, like this. Very good cackling.
George is dressing up as a dinosaur.
Dinosaur.
Grr.
A scary dinosaur.
Rebecca and Richard Rabbit are here with Mr. Rabbit.
Oh, what a sight!
Has the party started yet?
No, you're very early.
Hello! I'm a witch! George is a dinosaur.
Grr.
What are you?
I'm a carrot gone bad.
Ooh!
And Richard is a monster carrot.
Is that what a monster carrot looks like?
Yes.
Let's go and get the others for the party.
This is Susie Sheep's house.
Oh, that is scary.
We've come to get Susie for the pumpkin party.
Ooh, ha, 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 ha.
Hello, Susie. What are you?
I'm a beautiful vampire.
What's a vampire?
I don't know.
Oh, it's someone who sleeps all day and stays awake all night.
Ooh.
Let's get the others.
This is Pedro Pony's house. But no animals are living in it.
Ah!
Mr. Bull has found a bird's nest.
Look at that! Little birdies nesting in your tree, Madam Gazelle.
Please, can I see the birdies?
Okay, Peppa. We can watch from the windows.
Ooh, lovely birdies.
I think there's something else higher up the tree. Look what's here!
Buzzy bees!
Let's see what else there is. I say, look at this!
It's an owl!
Oh, I think I see something else. Onward and upward! Aha! You've got bats, Madam Gazelle!
Ah, my friends the bats. They remind me of the old country.
And what's this?
Ah, my Christmas decorations!
And a fairy!
That is the fairy I put on the little tree all those years ago.
It's a magnificent tree. A wonderful home to so many little animals.
Yes, this tree should not be chopped down.
Hooray!
But wait, if the tree stays, what will happen to my house?
Well, eventually it will fall over.
But I need a house to live in.
Oh.
I've got an idea. We'll put your house in the tree. Mr. Bull, the crane, please.
Right you are!
It's a tree house!
Yes, it is wonderful. I have always wanted to live in a tree house. Thank you, everyone. All having fun?
Yes! Yes, Mummy Pig!
Oh, Teddy, you look a bit under the weather.
What do you mean?
Teddy is a bit muddy.
Oh, I took Penguin to the doll hospital and now he's as good as new.
What's a doll hospital?
It's where dolls go to get better. They get washed, filled up with stuffing, and even get new voices.
You are my best friend,
Susie.
I love you a lot,
Susie.
Ooh,
Mummy, can we take Teddy to the doll hospital, please?
What a good idea.
This is the doll hospital.
Hello, Miss Rabbit.
Hello, Peppa. Welcome to the doll hospital, where we turn dolls like this into dolls like this.
Ooh.
Have you got a sick dolly?
Yes.
What is it? A mouse or a dog?
It's a bear.
Well, we have got our work cut out, haven't we? Ah! And a dinosaur. Are you booking them both in?
Yes, please.
Okay, so tell me, little bear, what have you been doing to get so poorly?
Teddy has been rolling down hills, jumping in muddy puddles and being sat on.
It's no wonder you're not looking your best. There'll be no more rolling down hills, jumping in muddy puddles or being sat on once I've finished with you.
But Teddy likes doing those things.
You do seem a bit floppy. Nothing some extra stuffing won't fix.
What do you mean?
Look, this elephant is a bit sad, but he just needs more stuffing.
Teddy likes being floppy, thank you, Miss Rabbit.
Would Mr. Dinosaur like some extra stuff?
Inside the forest, there's a little house. And inside the house was a bowl of porridge.
Georgie Pig was very hungry, so he ate it all up. Yum, yum, yum. But just as he finished, Baby Bear walked in and said, "Oi, did you eat my magic porridge?" Georgie said, "Yes." Baby Bear said, "That was magic porridge. It will make you go very big." And then Georgie Pig began to grow. He grew and he grew and he grew until he was taller than all of the trees in the forest. The end. Are you sleepy, George?
No.
Not even a little bit?
No.
Okay, I'll do a bit more story. Baby Bear said there is a box of golden treasure at the end of the world. But it's too far for me to go because I'm too little. Georgie said, I will carry you there. So Georgie Pig walked to the end of the world. He walked and he walked and he walked. Are you sleepy yet?
No.
He walked through forests, across mountains, across seas. And are you sleepy yet?
No.
He walked all the way to the end of the world and found a big box of golden treasure.
Oh, my ankle. I can still hop to work. No, you stay here and get better. But I've got so much work to do. I'll do your work for you. Which job is first?
The supermarket.
Okay, Rebecca, look after your auntie.
Yes, Mummy.
Mummy Rabbit has arrived at the supermarket.
Thank goodness you're here, Miss Rabbit. Miss Rabbit is ill. I'll be doing her job today.
Are you not Miss Rabbit?
No, I'm her sister, Mummy Rabbit. Is this where I sit?
Yes. Have you ever worked a checkout before?
No.
How much is this?
Oh, I don't know.
I've got a voucher.
Do you take book tokens?
Can I pay with a card?
Susie Sheep is dressed up in her nurse's costume.
Don't worry, I'm only a pretend nurse. Stick your tongue out and say, ah.
Ah.
Rebecca Rabbit's house. Who's speaking, please?
It's Mummy Rabbit. Is everything okay?
Yes.
Good, because this job is going to take me all day.
What about Miss Rabbit's other jobs?
We'll need more help.
Miss Rabbit's ice cream stall.
Daddy, why are you buying an ice cream?
Oh, Peppa, I was on the way to the gym when I thought an ice cream would be nice.
Miss Rabbit is ill. You've got to sell the ice cream today.
Oh, oh, I'm an expert at ice cream.
Can I have a cherry ice cream?
Super potato!
Wow! Oh, my hat is blown off! Help me, Super Potato!
By the power of vegetables, I am here! Aha!
Thank you, Super Potato!
Remember, kids, always eat your five a day. Fruit and vegetables keep us alive. Always remember to eat your five.
And now we have a very special guest. Can you guess who it is?
It's not my daddy, is it?
No.
It's not my daddy, is it?
No, it is nobody's daddy.
Is it my mummy then?
No, it is no relation of anyone here.
The special guest coming to see you today is...
Super Potato is coming.
Hooray!
But before he does, we must call him... Super Potato!
Super Potato!
Very good. I'll just go and see if he is outside. Keep shouting.
Super Potato! Super Potato!
By the power of vegetables, I am here!
Hooray!
Wonderful! Now, who has a question they would like to ask Super Potato?
Ask me anything you like about fruit and vegetables. Anything!
What is the tallest building you've ever jumped?
What's that? Why do I like carrots so much? I'll tell you why. Because they are so tasty!
Can you run faster than a train?
Which vegetable makes you run fast? That's a good question. I would have to say a Brussels sprout.
Have you ever eaten a potato?
Fruit and vegetables keep us alive. Always remember to eat your five.
Doctors now recommend you eat seven a day.
Always remember to eat your seven.
Right. Let's all give Super Potato a nice big clap for coming to see us today.
Thank you, thank you. And remember, kids, eat fruit and vegetables.
Super Potato has left the building.
Oh, dear. Did I miss him?
Yes!
He was brilliant.
Well, it was lovely to see you all, but I'd better be going too. Bye.
Come on, children. Let's wave Mr. Potato goodbye.
Rocket engines!
Peppa and her family have come to the market to do their shopping.
Fresh apples!
Can we buy some apples, please?
What kind would you like? Big or small? Red or green?
We would like the apples that taste nice.
Why don't you try one?
Mmm, lovely.
A bag of the lovely apples, please.
Thank you.
Cheese! Cheese!
Yum, yum.
George loves cheese.
I've got a very smelly cheese here. Maybe Daddy Pig should give it a sniff.
The smell of the cheese has knocked Daddy Pig off his feet.
Wow, that's what I call a strong cheese.
Good, isn't it?
Mmm, yum, yum. George likes smelly cheese.
May we buy that one, please?
Of course.
Thank you.
Fish! Nice fresh fish!
Can we buy some fish, please?
Okay, I've got trout, haddock, mackerel or squid. What would you like?
They all look good.
How about I give you some of each? Then you can make a lovely fish pie.
Fish pie, yummy.
There you go.
Thank you very much.
Fish, apples, cheese.
Here is Mr. Fox's store.
Bananas, flower tools, handbags.
I'm selling anything, really. What do you want?
Nothing, thank you. We've bought everything we need.
Apples, cheese and fish.
Ow! Why didn't you come to me first? I've got all of that.
Do you sell apples?
You've never seen apples like these. They're made of wood.
Wooden apples?
Hey?
Why not open your birthday present? It's a boat trip.
A boat trip? That's just what I wanted. Let's go! There's nothing better than sailing a boat. You could go anywhere you want in a sailing boat. We could head for the tropics or have an Arctic adventure. We might even see a whale.
It's just a day trip, dear.
This is the canal.
Now, where's the sailing boat?
We're going on this canal boat.
I see. We use the canal boat to get to the sailing boat.
No, dear. We're going on this boat for your birthday, and we're sailing it down the canal.
But on a canal, you can only go this way and that way.
It'll be fun.
Come on, Dad. It is a boat.
Yes, Danny, you're right. A boat. On the water.
All aboard.
Oh, I wanted to say that.
Oh, I'm sorry. Go on then.
All aboard! Raise the sail!
Oh, where is the sail? Canal boats do not have sails.
You just push this button to make the boat go.
Ah, thank you, Mummy Dog. And we're away.
Mrs. Duck is going faster than our boat.
Want a race, do you, Mrs. Duck? Full steam ahead! Can't this thing go any faster?
No, this is the top speed.
Oh.
Anyway, you want to slow down. We're coming to a mountain.
Ah!
Look out! There's a mountain in front.
We're going to crash straight into it.
No, we're going into the tunnel.
There is a tunnel through the mountain.
It's all gone dark. And our voices sound funny.
We sailed straight through the middle of a mountain. Ha ha! This canal boat is actually quite fun.
Look, here comes another mountain.
And that means another tunnel.
Not this time.
Oh, there's no tunnel.
So what do we do?
We're going uphill.
There's no way in the world.
Could have lost Mr. Dinosaur anywhere. We've been to so many places today.
We went to the shops, to the playground, to the park.
George cannot remember where he left Mr. Dinosaur.
Oh, well. Mr. Dinosaur is lost forever then.
Don't worry, George. Somebody will have found Mr. Dinosaur.
Yes, and when people find lost things, they take them to the police station.
So that's where Mr. Dinosaur will be.
This is the police station. Here are Police Officer Squirrel and Police Officer Panda. They are doing important police work.
Very good donuts, these.
Yes, donuts really are the best.
The police like donuts.
Hello, hello, hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
That is how the police say hello.
And how may we help you today?
Dinosaur.
George has lost Mr. Dinosaur.
Don't worry, George. I'm sure you'll find your dinosaur.
All you've got to do is keep your ears and eyes open.
Actually, we were hoping some kind person might have found George's toy dinosaur and brought it here.
I see. We'll need to question George. It's just routine.
Please describe your dinosaur in your own words.
Take your time.
Use as many words as you like.
Dinosaur.
Dinosaur. Excellent description.
We do have some lost dinosaurs in the back. Follow me.
Thank you.